In this video, you will learn how to use Application Tool 2 to configure the Regio RCX. Welcome to Regin Academy. The Regio RCX is a series of smart room controllers from Regin. Configuration can be done over Bluetooth with Regin smartphone app Regin Go, but in this video we will focus on our configuration software Application Tool 2. Application Tool 2 is available to download for free from Regin's website. It's easily found under Products, Software Tools. But you can of course also simply use the site search function to locate it. Simply click on the download link and install the software. When launched, Application Tool 2 opens a dialog where you can create an offline project, open an existing project, or search for a device via either serial connection or a network. The AppLoader function can be used for just upgrading a controller. Let's start by connecting a Regio RCX using the serial interface. Attach the data wires like this. Negative A to terminal 3 and positive B to terminal 4. Next, we start a new project and select the appropriate application, which software version, and which controller model we are working with. In this example, we are using an RCX-THCVP-D. That is a model with a full complement of built-in sensors and a display. You can then use the Search Serial function to identify and connect to your Regio RCX controller. Application Tool 2 will prompt you to download any available software updates, ensuring that you'll be working with the latest release and you'll be able to update the controller firmware if necessary. To manually check for updates, go to Tools and Update from Cloud. In Application Tool 2, the left-hand side of the screen contains the dashboard with a few subsections. There is the overview page where you can see the current values of system and room settings. Next, we have the Actual Values page, followed by Inputs and Outputs, where you can view the actual values of all the IOs and the built-in sensors. The Alarms page is an overview of all active or inactive alarms. And lastly, the About page provides identification information about the connected controller. When setting up the Regio RCX, your focus should be on the configuration section. Let's start with the control functions. For this example, let's set sequence 1 to heating, sequence 2 to VAV, that is variable air volume, and sequence 3 to cooling. You can then choose to edit the maximum and minimum limits, but we will stick to the default values for this example. We can set the VAV control source to a selection of parameters. Let's connect it to cooling demand, CO2 levels, and dehumidification. Next, we can configure the controller state, as well as decide if we want forced ventilation to be active and what variables to trigger it. For presence detection, let's enable the onboard PIR sensor. Note, however, that no changes have yet been loaded to the controller. To do so, click the Load Configuration icon in the upper left corner. For confirmation, we can go back to the Actual Values page to see that the selected sequences are now running. If necessary, we can enable an extra zone to control heating or cooling. But the next step of the configuration process is the Inputs and Outputs page. This is where we configure any additional inputs, other than the onboard sensors, and connections related to the sequences configured earlier. In this example, we will add an external temperature sensor to Universal Input 1. As for the outputs, we will add a thermal cooling valve to Universal Output 1 and set it to Normally Open, a thermal heating valve to Universal Output 2, Normally Open, and VAV to Analog Output 1, with a 0 to 10 volt control signal. Analog Output 2 can also be used as a condensation input, intended for Regens condensation detector KG-A/1. When finished, let's load the new settings to the controller. With that, we have made enough configurations to let the Regio RCX function. However, there are more settings available if you want to fine-tune your configuration. On the Setpoints page, for example, we can configure the different setpoints for temperature, CO2, humidity, etc., as well as how much adjustment is allowed when operating the controller via the onboard display. Here, we have set a heating setpoint of 22 and a cooling setpoint of 24 with an allowance of plus minus 2 degrees adjustment. Let's also have a look at the Display and Menus page. Here we can adjust the settings of the display, configuring what should be shown and the brightness of the LED lights. Let's set the display to show the temperature value and enable it to alternate between temperature and CO2. The setpoint mode decides what appears on the display when the up-down buttons are pressed. In this example, we'll let the setpoint adjustment appear. Configuring the display appearance, we'll set the brightness to 100 when active, and the dimmed mode to 25. If we want the display to dim itself after a certain time of inactivity, we can do that too. Let's decide that the display should dim after 30 seconds and turn completely off after 60 seconds. To keep a close eye on the CO2 levels, let's also enable the LED indication. This will make the onboard LED indicator function as a warning light, with a yellow light at one level, 800 in this example, and red at another, 1000 in this case. Finally, we can also enable or disable the different menu items available on the display. For this example, let's enable Setpoint Adjust and the CO2 menu page, but set the remaining items to Disabled or Read-Only to make them viewable but not adjustable. Under Analog Inputs, we can adjust the filter time for sensors. Under Controller Settings, we can set values for P-band and I-time, and Alarm Settings makes it possible to adjust alarm levels when communicating to a central SCADA system. The next three sections are grouped as Manual Auto and allows for manual control. Under Remote Input Values, you can set your own values to override actual values. This is useful for testing a configuration. For example, by manually setting the room temperature to 17 degrees, you can see if the heating sequence functions as intended. On the Manual Auto page, you are able to manually control the various sequences. For example, if we set the heating output to 50%, it will remain in that state regardless of the actual room temperature. Hardware control is where you can manually set values for the input and output signals. At the bottom of the list, we find the controller ID page. This is where you can enter information to easily identify a particular device. The communication page is the place to configure the role of the device in a larger network. This is also where we set the Bluetooth function. Whether it should be always on, only active for a set time after startup, or manually activated. Bluetooth can also be turned completely off after commissioning. We can also configure the behavior of the device should it lose communication, with the option to have it revert to default outputs with or without communication enabled. Lastly, the reset page offers three ways to reboot the controller. If you just want to reset all variables to their default values, this can also be done via the Tools menu. This area is also where you can change the passwords for the different user levels. And where you can save the current configuration as a file, which can then be used to load another device quickly, without having to go through all the configuration steps for each controller. You can work with configuration files without being connected to a controller, allowing you to create a configuration in advance, ready to be loaded to one or several controllers. These files can also be transferred to a smartphone for use with the app Regen Go in the field. And that's it. You should now be more than ready to configure the Regio RCX with Application Tool 2. Thank you for watching this video from Regen Academy.